stationed here. Leave no one standing.
Oh, what it do, guys, and welcome back to another Warframe video. Now in today's video, we're going to be looking at a Warframe that can help us crack open our Barracketeer relics, ready for those Barracketeer weekends. So if you're looking for a Warframe that is going to be able to navigate tile sets like Exterminate, Sabotage, Capture, any kind of missions like that, then look no further, because Titania and a Razor Wing build is going to be our go-to Warframe here. Now we're also going to be infusing Gauss's Thermal Sunder, and we're going to have a little look at this build right here on the screen and start off with Razor Wing. Now when we go ahead and have a look at this ability, the idea and the main focus that we need to go ahead and do is make sure we got some energy and make sure that our duration and our efficiency isn't hit too much. Okay, you don't need to go and bump them up much further than this, but if you are struggling for a build, it's totally fine if you want to go and put in more efficiency or more duration, but for the most part that's not what we're really looking to complement. Just make sure that it's not hit too hard, and honestly you should just be okay. If you've got a prime flow, you can just basically leave it like that. I promise you, you'll be all right. But from there onwards, the main stat and the main ability we are going to be looking towards is Gauss's Thermal Sunder. Now this ability is genuinely really strong. It's mostly because of the way that heat works inside the game, being able to armor strip, being able to do dart, being able to do damage over time, stuff like that. We're going to be focusing on a lot of range. As much range as we could possibly get onto the builds, the better, by all means. We want to hit enemies as far away as possible. Now we can also use cold within this, but we don't use it as often. I mostly end up sticking towards the heat. Again, lower tier tile sets, things like exterminate, capture, sabotage, we're just going to be nuking enemies absolutely effortlessly when they come into our vision and when they approach our Warframe or when we approach them. From there onwards, a little bit of strength. If you don't have Umbral Intensify, it's totally fine. Just try and get some strength on your build wherever you possibly can. I don't really recommend Blind Rage as a mod here, because you will hit your duration. Well, you will hit your drain per second, your efficiency. So Transient Fortitude, you can get away with. You use Prime Continuity, so you can go meet it in the middle. Now, Razor Wing Blitz is an augment that you don't necessarily need. You can start off without this by all means. Titania can go very, very quick, and she can end up speeding into walls and this and that and knocking yourself away. And oh my goodness, it can be really hard to control. So don't feel like that this is a necessity. If you want to go ahead and go without this, that's totally fine. But we're mostly using this for the flight speeds. If you do find yourself hitting into walls and so forth, use the Prime Surefooted to go ahead and help you out. Otherwise, because it's a drain, a continuous drain, we're going to use Arcane Energize going to look after us. We're going to use things like Preparation, so as soon as we start the mission, we got plenty of energy. Our energy is completely maxed out so that we can go and jump straight into our Razor Wing ability and then just spam free on every enemy that we come across. And then from there as well, again, we're protecting the energy. Energize, Nullifier, Preparation, Flow. All of these things synergize very well. If you see any doors that have the magnetic proc on them, do not panic, simply just go ahead and fly straight through it. This will go ahead and protect you from that magnetic proc, which basically means you will not lose your energy, and this way we can just keep going and keep doing what we want to do. Enemy radar is my choice of augment here. It's an aura. It's entirely up to you what you want to go and run, but enemy radar just allows me to look and see where I'm going. Besides from all of that, it's a very simplistic build. It's a very quick build. You can get straight from A to B, do your objective, as you can see effortlessly on the screen. Do your objective, get your relics, get your ducats, and go ahead and get everything that you need from Barracketeer. You can also use this outside of Barrow relics and so forth. If you're just looking for a general exterminate thing, or even if sorties pop up, you can go ahead and use this build. It's totally fine. So yeah, that's mostly about it, by all means. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I'm going to try and keep it as short and as sweet as I possibly can. If you guys do want to go and see more builds like this, please go and give it a thumbs up. Please go and leave a comment or any kind of feedback as well. If there's something in here that I didn't see or something in here that you guys would include in your builds, let me know. It's always nice to be able to improve builds and share case ideas. There's no right, there's no wrong, there's just pros and cons. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I will see you guys again in the next one. Take care.